श्रीमती राजश्री बिरला जी हमारे बीच, हमारे विशिष्ट मेहमान, हम उनका हार्दिक स्वागत अभिनंदन करते हैं।
Respected dignitaries on the dais, my fellow students, ladies and gentlemen, I am indeed delighted to be with all of you here today to address the third Indian Student Parliament. I must compliment the MIT School of Government and other government arms for this excellent initiative. Inspiring youth for strengthening democracy, I believe, is an idea whose time has come. I have been asked to share my thoughts on this topic. This is a subject I believe in, so I am going to talk about it for a few minutes. What I believe you can all do to strengthen our democracy. I talk to you with head and heart. I talk with you as I would talk to youngsters whom I would consider as part of the larger Indian family. You and I belong to this India family. I look upon you, the students, leaders of our country, as a hope. In you, we see the leaders of tomorrow today. So the first point I would like to make is that you are our future. How our democracy will shape up as we go along is entirely in your hands. So you must seize the future and make a game-changing difference to our country. And this brings me to the second point, that what are our strengths and what are our weaknesses? And how can you help strengthen the strengths and weaken the weaknesses? First, let me come to our strengths. Ours is the largest, most vibrant democracy in the world. Nowhere in the world can you find elections conducted on this magnitude of scale as in India. We are a diverse people, with many religions coexisting, 23 officially recognized languages, and more than 20 dialects. Despite this composition, we are a country where the government believes in consensus. It takes decisions also in consensual manner, notwithstanding aberrations that have been surfacing in the recent past. I'm sure all of you will agree that this can be traced to the constraints faced because of the undercurrents in politics, coupled with an unfortunate derailment of value systems amidst several sections of our people. Next to our democracy, our economy and our intellectual capital offers a lot of hope. India has spawned world-class institutions in engineering, the basic sciences, medicine, and management. These investments in brain power have paid rich dividends. In nuclear and space technologies, for instance, India ranks among the leading nations. India boasts of the world's third best largest scientific and technical manpower. So we can take justifiable pride in the fact that we have made a mark on the intellectual map of India, or in world map. India is a happening country, and these are very positive changes. According to BRICS projection, 2040, India will become an economic powerhouse. It will be in the league of China and the USA. Two factors that will catapult India to the top include the contribution of the corporate sector, the role of industry in elevating India's stature as the manufacturing hub, the power excellent service provider, and among the intellectual capital of the globe. And second, progressive government policies. The prognosis about our future seems encouraging on the economic front. That said, our current environment of governance is wanting in several aspects. As tomorrow's leaders today, the onus to evolve into change agents and help put processes and change mindsets so that our democracy can be strengthened is on you. You have to raise your decibel levels and root for transparency and accountability to a far higher pitch. In your life now, as a student leader, you must ensure that these virtues are not nurtured in campuses. The next point I would like to make is that each of you have reached the age of voting. So you must cast your vote. Right away ensure that your name is on the roster of voters. There are other issues which make our heads hang in shame. For instance, women abuse and the poverty that still exists in our country. On women abuse, I think there are systemic issues. In my view, the severest deterrent to such base and inhuman acts must immediately be put in place. Systemic issues and mindset changes will take time, but you must make a promise to respect women and to bring in gender equity. These times are sad for all of us. We have lost our respect globally on this score. So my submission to you would be to, and the loss of poverty alleviation is one of the very important point. So my submission to you would be to intensify the struggle for inclusive growth. And you can do it. Make helping others and thinking beyond yourself a part of your life. And now, some final words before I conclude. I recall what the former American president, Mr. Franklin Roosevelt said, and I quote, "We cannot always build the future for our youth, but we can build the youth for the future." I think I would like to repeat, we cannot always build the future for our youth, but we can build the youth for the future. So my appeal to you is try and do your best in life.